Hey, what's up? Today we're going to take a look at Xiaomi's 4K drone, the Mi Drone. Spoiler alert, it's actually very impressive. So let's roll those establishing shots and let's go. In the box, you'll find the drone, the camera unit, a remote control, propeller protectors, two sets of propellers, a battery, and a charger. This is some footage I've captured with the HD drone last year, and this is at full resolution, and I'll scale it up to fit the frame. And the 4K image right here, it just looks so much more vibrant, less noisy, and a lot more crisp. I was really impressed to see the difference. So let's look at the camera. That needs to be mounted to the bottom of the drone, and on the back of the camera you'll find a micro SD slot. The camera's stabilizing gimbal is very impressive. Here you can see me move the drone very hard and suddenly stopping it, having the drone tilt quite a lot. And now look at the footage captured with that drone, and you can see how well this gimbal is performing, as you really don't notice the tilting drone at all. It really feels like you're flying around with a Steadicam. When you're moving forward in full speed, you'll probably see its propellers in screen for a second or so, but usually this adjusts to that quite quickly. You can really capture some perfectly stabilized shots even when the drone is in somewhat of a bumpy ride. The Mi Drone has a pretty straightforward remote control, allowing you to ascend and descend, go forward and backwards, move left and right, and rotate the drone left and right as well. On the back, there's two dials. The left dial allows you to tilt the camera up and down, and the right dial can be set up to change the exposure of the camera. The camera only pans up and down, as any other camera movements are made by moving the drone itself. There's also a return to home switch, which will return your drone to its position of takeoff. I've tested that on several occasions and it came back really accurate. The remote has a stand allowing you to place your phone in it, which will display a map or a live view of the drone during flight. Going on your first flight is pretty easy. First, install the props and the camera to the drone, insert the battery, turn on the drone and the remote controller by short and long pressing the on-off switch, after which you'll need to set it up with the Mi Drone app, which is available as an English or as a native Chinese app. If any firmware updates are available, I would advise to install those, as it might include the latest no-fly zones and possible safety, performance, and stability updates. There's a switch to automatically take off, but I personally prefer taking off manually. You can do so by moving both sticks on the remote to the bottom center, which will start the engine. You can now use the left stick to ascend and off you go. It can fly up to 60 meters per second horizontally, and ascending and descending speeds are 6 and 2 meters per second. The remote should reach for about 4 kilometers, but the drone is limited to, I believe, a half a kilometer right now, and going 120 meters high. Its battery has a 5100 mAh capacity, allowing for a fly time of about 26 minutes. In the Mi Drone app, you can switch between a live camera view and a map view. The map view shows you any potential no-fly zones, and it can be used to send the drone to an actual location from the map as well. Again, I personally prefer flying manual, but it's there. And there's also an option to have the drone automatically fly around a circle from a set location, which is actually really cool. Also good to know that when the battery gets low or when the connection gets lost, the drone will automatically return to its takeoff position. Overall, the Mi Drone is really impressive. It flies really well, records really impressive, stabilized footage, and it's really cheap. It's still one of the most affordable drones that shoot really decent footage, especially considering its price. Obviously, it's not like you're flying an Alexa or Red, but it's a very good image for the price of the drone. Since they've updated the app to set a lot more settings on the camera, like the exposure and such, this drone is actually very usable. So if you're looking for a really good drone in a more affordable price range, I can definitely recommend the Mi Drone. It's not as small as some of the newer drones that are on the market right now, but coming in for about 30 or 40% of the price of some of its competitors, this drone might be exactly what you're looking for. So that was it for the 4K Mi Drone. I hope you've learned something today. As always, thank you guys for watching, and I hope to see y'all soon. Peace.